My gosh, I don't think I've ever been more surprised by a theme park. This is Dollywood in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. I recently got to visit the park for the first time in over 11 years. So I had been here before, but I was like really young. I remembered nothing, and I had only rode Mystery Mine when I first went, so I didn't remember anything. And I went back, and I was absolutely blown away. So today I'm going to be reviewing Dollywood on a few different categories and just talking about them overall. So let's get right into this. So talking about Dollywood's roller coasters, they have a pretty good lineup. You have Thunderhead, which is a GCI, which is a really, really good wooden coaster. That's one of my all-time favorites. Tennessee Tornado is a great aero looper, one of the best aeros out there. There is Wild Eagle, which was the first B&M wing coaster in North America, and it was pretty good, actually. Definitely a little overhated. Fire Chaser Express is a pretty good family coaster, and Mystery Mine, well, that was quite the interesting experience. I'll just leave it at that. And they also have Blazing Fury, which is an indoor roller coaster slash dark ride, which had a really surprising moment at the end. I'm not going to spoil that, but if you haven't ridden it, there's a surprising little moment at the end. And of course, their kiddie coaster, which is Whistlepunk Chaser, which is all right. You know, it's a Coco Cruiser clone. There are a few of these out there. And of course, there is Lightning Rod, which was not open, so I did not get to ride it. And that kind of hurt my experience because I didn't get to ride Lightning Rod, which is this freaking huge RMC over there that I'm just staring at, sitting there. I could have rode it, but no, it's been down for so long, and it was just sitting there, like a freaking RMC right there, just sitting, a top 10 coaster in the world probably, and it just hurt to just look at it, and it just really sucked. But yeah, Lightning Rod is still an RMC, so that makes their lineup that much better if they had it open. But yeah, overall, they have a good coaster lineup, and family rides, I mean, you know, this park doesn't have too many family rides. They have the occasional carnival-like section of the park. They do have a train, which is really cool, that takes you around the park and kind of shows you historic places. And they also show you the new area coming, which is Wildwood Grove. So that was cool. I really like the train. It is loud, and it is long, too. They also have two thrill rides at the park. One is Drop Line, which is one of their newer rides. And, of course, Barnstormer, which is a really, really good type of ride. I loved that. It was my first S&S Scream and Swing, and it was a lot of fun. I enjoyed that a lot. So overall, they do have some good rides at this park, some really good rides, actually. Thunderhead is by far my favorite, but I haven't rode Lightning Rod, so that'll probably change eventually. I don't know when I'm gonna go back, but I will definitely go back if Lightning Rod ever opens again, which I'm sure it will, but you know. Okay, now food-wise, this park is phenomenal. I got to try two different foods when I went here, which was cinnamon bread and lumberjack pizza. Oh my gosh, both of them were great, but the cinnamon bread was freaking amazing. By far the best theme park food I have ever had. It just melts in your mouth, and the crisp, tasty feel of it. It's doughy and just crispy, and oh my gosh, just thinking about it makes my mouth water. It was so phenomenal. I love it so much. I was really just blown away by how good it was. And then, of course, there is the lumberjack pizza, which this was really good. I got a cheese pizza here, and it was when we were getting rained out by the thunderstorm, this huge storm that was just taking us out, and I just went in there and got some pizza, and it was really good. I liked this, actually. I was not expecting too much out of it since it's like theme park food. No, it was pretty good. So overall, they do have some really good food here, and the atmosphere of this park is fantastic. It is absolutely phenomenal. The whole park is just charming. You know, you feel like you're in this old-timey woodland place. You have the train smoke going around. There's some country music. Like, I'm not talking the new kind of bad one. I'm talking like the old-timey country music just playing everywhere. It's just phenomenal. The atmosphere in this park is great. I love it. It really does feel like you're in Tennessee and you're in the Smoky Mountains. And overall, yeah, this park is so charming. It is absolutely beautiful. Is it on the charmingness level of Busch Gardens Williamsburg? Well, almost, but not exactly. I mean, Busch Gardens is, of course, the world's most beautiful theme park, apparently, and I do believe it. But this is still a really nice-looking park, and they have so much scenery, and the theming in this park is phenomenal. There's theming all over the place. It is great. Now, let's talk about convenience. Are the paths easy to find? Are the rides close to each other, or are they spread out? Are there bins on the ride platforms? Is this place located in a good place? And convenience is fantastic. They have bins on all the ride platforms. I'm not quite sure about Lightning Rod. Didn't ride that, so I'm assuming it does, but I don't know. All the rides had bins, so you were completely covered. You don't need to buy lockers at all. And this place is in a really good area too. I mean, Pigeon Forge is a huge tourist destination. It is also a money trap. So it was really nice. I mean, just the whole convenience of this place is great. Now, if you are a first-time guest, maybe the paths will be a little hard to find, but overall the park is low-key, just a giant circle. So you should be pretty good if you have a map. And it's just great. I mean, it's really good to know you're gonna have bins on the ride platforms. You don't need to buy lockers. Stuff like that is just what I really like in a park. Now, how are the operations in this park? And let me just say, these are some really good operations. I thought they were pretty good. Now, I did hear lightning rod dispatches in like 30 seconds to 45 seconds, which is insane. Thunderhead was getting dispatched in about 45 to a minute. Same with Tennessee Tornado. So they were doing overall really good with dispatches. That is also a plus to this park. So yeah, overall operations were just really good. But as you can tell, I really love Dollywood. The park was fantastic. Theming was great. Scenery was amazing. I absolutely love this place and would love to go back. Is it my favorite park I've been to? I'm not quite sure if I would say that. However, it is for sure in my top three, maybe top two. Hershey Park and King's Dominion are really close to my heart, and so is this one. They are my top three parks. I can't really tell you the order. That'll come sometime soon. But yeah, Dollywood, overall fantastic. Great coasters, great food, great times. So for Dollywood's final score, I will be giving it a 9 out of 10. This is a fantastic theme park. I love it. There's great food here, great rides, great atmosphere. They have some nice shows. I didn't really see any, but you'd walk by and you just see shows everywhere. It's great. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Post your comments down in the section below. What do you think of Dollywood? Don't forget to like and subscribe. And until next time, Coaster fans, I will see you later.